Hello, this is a video to show you how to get an account for meetingwizard.com. People who need to schedule or work with meetings with many other colleagues, professionals, Meeting Wizard is an excellent tool to use. We are suggesting that especially people that may schedule or reschedule IEP meetings in which there are many professionals that need to be invited, plus the appearance to an IEP meeting, to consider using Meeting Wizard. So this is how you start an account. You go to a web browser, type in www.meetingwizard.com, and Meeting Wizard will come up. It says schedule meetings and events, propose times, review responses, confirm a time. It's easy to use, it's free, no downloads are required. So I'm going to click get started now. And it says welcome, create an account, choose one of the following: propose one or more dates and times, announce a specific start date and time. What we want to do, this is just the first time using it, and I'm going to set up an account. And the people that will need to set up accounts are people that schedule meetings, probably special education teachers, principals possibly, administrators. Secretaries could help out with this, but the best way to do it is if you are involved in the meeting, because you check your schedule if you start the ideas of trying to set up a meeting. So it says propose time. So I'm going to pick, let's go ahead and I look at my calendar. I notice Tuesday, October the 9th at 9 o'clock in the morning. And I'm going to add that time right there, and it's going to last for 30 minutes. And we're going to continue. And the purpose is I need a IEP meeting. And now we're going to put email addresses in. I can select from my address book, but I don't have anybody in there. So I'm going to invite mhiefner@76.gmail.com. And once I put in someone in there, they should go automatically to my address book. So I start building my address book in this system. And we need to meet for an IEP meeting on Nita. That's the student's name. And we're going to talk about math progress and social problems in this IEP meeting. And the proposed location, I'm going to put down Chicago Street School, Educators Conference Room. And we go down a little bit farther here, and it says organizer will also be participating. I'm the organizer, and actually my email is going to be hiefner@juno.com. Include my contact information. Yes, after all responses are received, send a general reminder to participants. Send me an email update after all responses are received. And we just got one other person I'm inviting the meeting right now. But if you invited four or five, you would get an email to you saying everybody's responded on the possible times. And you could list multiple times. And then when you finally do declare the meeting time later in the process, you can have the system send a general reminder like one day before or 2 days before. Let's continue. Please log in to continue with Meeting Wizard. Well, I don't have a login. Well, I do have a login, but I'm going to set this one up. So I'm going to, for new users, set up your own free account. And so once again, this is what you'll be doing. I'm going to put Andrew Hiefner, and I'm going to use my Juno account that I've had for many years. And the time zone that I operate from is Eastern time. I think that's correct right there. Select the country. Let's see if we can get United States. Well, I'm going to have to. And you only do this the very first time. This is because I'm setting up the account. You don't always have to do this. And I'm just going to type in a very simple password. And scroll down here a little bit more by registering your account, terms of use, and basically they keep this all private. The only ad that they try to run is the very top hand corner, and this they do support GoMeeting, which is a like a Skype device. But I have never noticed junk mail from them. This is a nice free service that is offered, and they do it with just very few ads. And I need to continue. And I'm going to tell it to go ahead and remember my password, because this is my computer I always use. And so here's my new user account, Andrew Hefner, hefner@juno.com. And you can set up with your school account because it's a pretty, it's a very safe system. Close and continue. Now I'm back to where, because I just set up my account, I'm back to scheduling the meeting. And I'm the organizer, Andrew Hefner. I need an IEP meeting face-to-face, and I'm trying to schedule with M. Hefner. And I've included one time, proposed times, but I could include multiple times. Let's, if I go up here and look at edit details. See, down here, I've got just the one. I've just got the one time, but I can add more. I can select date and click. I just added October 4th at 8 o'clock p.m. But I can look at my one calendar and look ahead, and maybe October 16th at 3 o'clock. And then I also look again, and as notice I click select and it drops it down in there. Let's go out to October 21st, and I look at my calendar. I want to pick some different times so that for the flexibility finding a time that's agreeable to everybody that's involved in trying to schedule this meeting. And I've added more times in. I noticed some of these are 3 o'clock a.m. in the morning. That's not what I want. There's a 4 p.m. I dropped that in. So I've dropped in multiple times. Now I'm going to save edits. Now I'm back to reviewing what I've set up. And you'll notice on the screen are the different times, approximately 30 minutes where it's located. And I can send it now. Now I've sent it. And now I'm going to go to M. Hefner account, and that's a Gmail account, and we're going to see this Gmail that's come into my Gmail account. So like now I'm the other person, and see, here's in my account, meeting request reply from Andrew Hefner. So I click on this. And I look in here, it says, Andrew Hefner has invited you to the following meeting. Now, this is a Gmail account, but this would be any email account that either the school account or a parent account. So they get this notice. And you can click on it, or you can cut and paste it into your address bar. But if we click on it, it should open back to a meeting wizard. And it says, request for M. Hefner. It says the note on there. And we request in a certain time, and notice the times that I can check which times I'm available. I'm available there, and I'm available there, and I'm not going to check, no, I'm not available. But two of them I was available, and two of them I were not. I could type a little note back, thanks for the invite. This would be the parent. This is not the organizer. This is the person that is they've got the invite to this meeting. And then I click continue, and I could go and view all the responses to see what's happening. And there could be multiple people trying to schedule, but in this case it's just me and Andrew Hefner. And so this could build a grid, and you can see what's happening if you have multiple users. So I've already responded to it. I could exit out of this meeting wizard, and let's go back to the meeting wizard where I was at. And here, the last time we left this was the organizer. It said your meeting request has been sent. But if I would go back to my Hefner M screen, and let's go there. Let's go to this one right here, and let's go to Juno.com, because that was the account that I set up. I set up Juno.com, and I need to, and I've already logged in Hefner, and Juno email, it says no new email, but let's click there and see if anything does come in. Let's just see if there's, see if it came in junk mail. Yes, it did. It came in junk mail. See, when I set up my account, I got some emails from Meeting Wizard. And it's possible the first time they come in with you, you may need to retrieve it out of your junk mail and approve it to come into your mainstream mail. And here, meeting request, all responses received. And if I go here, it says, hi, Andrew, your requested invite. Everyone's responded. And so now I can go right back to Meeting Wizard here. And it's going to take me right back there. And look, it says, if it says on the screen that this one is available and they're available. And so I could pick which one I want to approve. And I could confirm it, and that would send out email messages, or I could invite more people. There's other choices that I could use in this system, and they're self-explanatory down there. Let's just go ahead and confirm it. And it says, event, you have 4 days until the start date. Reminder, and it says you could add more information. We could send this. It'll send the message back and to all that I've invited in the meeting. It'll say, this is the date the meeting's going to be. And so those emails have went out. This has just been kind of an overview. It's a very logical system, and it works very well. I hope you consider to use it to make the scheduling of your meetings more efficient. Thank you.